Bonjour à tous. Pour cette journée portes ouvertes dédiée au métier de l'international, nous avons Sonia Lorenzani avec nous. Nous attendons Monsieur Jalawad qui ne devrait pas tarder. Donc Sonia.
Welcome to this virtual open house dedicated to international problems. And both French and English can be used, so feel free to ask any questions. Off you go.
All right. Okay. Bonjour. Hello. Je suis Sonia Lorenzani. So I'll speak French and sometimes I'll speak English. So je vais commencer un peu avec le français. Donc je suis Sonia Lorenzani et je dirige le Bachelor of Business Administration. Donc c'est ce sujet que je viens vous rencontrer et je voulais partager quelques éléments avec vous pour le présenter. Ce BBA est un BBA en un an, entièrement en anglais, et il se déroule donc, il a comme positionnement Bac plus 3, c'est-à-dire qu'à la fin de l'année de votre BBA, vous aurez un équivalent de licence 3. C'est un diplôme universitaire à part entière. Donc à la fin de cette année de BBA, vous recevez votre diplôme de BBA, qui vous permet par la suite eh bien, de présenter, pourquoi pas, votre candidature afin d'intégrer certains masters de l'IAE ou autres. Alors, c'est un BBA qui est bâti autour de trois grands piliers. Tout d'abord, évidemment, la pratique concrète, opérationnelle, la compréhension opérationnelle, mais également la compréhension théorique de toutes les, disons, les matières qui entourent Business Administration, c'est-à-dire l'administration des entreprises. Nous accordons énormément d'importance également à tout ce qui est de l'ordre des soft skills. Alors, qu'est-ce que c'est que les soft skills ? Ce sont vos compétences personnelles qui vont faire la différence le moment venu, lorsque vous serez amené à vous présenter devant un recruteur afin de faire valoir non pas simplement votre compétence opérationnelle concrète liée à votre diplôme BBA, mais également votre personnalité, la compétence supplémentaire que vous allez apporter avec votre savoir-être, afin que, eh bien, savoir-faire et savoir-être puissent vous donner les meilleures opportunités et les meilleures chances de savoir agir et de le prouver en entreprise. Évidemment, il faut avoir un bon niveau d'anglais, puisque toutes les matières sont proposées en anglais. Et vous pouvez donc présenter votre candidature lorsque vous avez un diplôme Bac plus 2 dans n'importe quelle matière et spécialité. C'est-à-dire que vous n'avez pas obligation d'avoir déjà des connaissances dans le domaine de l'administration des entreprises pour pouvoir nous rejoindre. Je donne un exemple, une personne, je pense à une de nos anciennes étudiantes, qui venait d'une compétence plutôt liée aux sciences et qui avait donc comme compétence première plutôt le domaine des sciences. Elle est venue nous rejoindre afin de pouvoir compléter sa compétence première par une meilleure compréhension et une spécialisation dans le domaine du management et de l'administration des entreprises pour avoir une capacité à rentrer dans les entreprises qui puisse lui permettre de combiner les deux aspects, ces deux types de compétences. Et enfin, vous pouvez également nous rejoindre et en tout cas présenter votre candidature si vous avez votre bac, mais un bac qui se combine avec un minimum de 3 ans d'expérience professionnelle. Voilà pour la présentation en quelques mots.
Okay. Would you like to say a few words in English for maybe our viewers?
All right. Okay. Okay. Right. Well, just to recap on what I've just been told, BBA is a one-year full university degree, which is entirely taught in English. Right. It's an undergraduate degree, which is shaped around, I would say, three blocks or three major constituents. First of all, the understanding and the practical learning as much as theoretical knowledge about all topics related to business administration. And also the second block or the second constituent, which is of foremost importance to us, is soft skills. How can you, well, show your inner abilities as a person so that you show how, not only how competent you are, but also how agile you are and how able you are to go towards other people, understand their culture, and just join a group of people with the perfect knowledge of what you can provide in terms of inner abilities. And the last block is, well, it is the 4 to 6 month professional internship that you need to conduct in order to finalize and validate your BBA degree.
Thank you so much. We do have a question from Anna.
Okay.
She would like to study for her last year in IAE.
Okay.
And she would like to know if she can transfer to IAE BBA program for the last and third year. She does have 90 US credits for now.
Okay.
Could she?
Well, I'm not sure about credits, Anna, so I need to review that, okay? The BBA will be, European ECTS will be 120 to apply. Okay, and I'm not sure about the American credits, to be honest, so I'm not going to tell you anything. The best would be for you to get in touch with me. Maybe I could just tell Anna my email address.
I think it is already in the link.
Oh, is it?
In the description.
Okay.
Probably.
Well, anyway, my email address is sonia.lorenzani@unif-codeazur.fr. Okay? So, Anna, I don't want to really investigate. I need to investigate on that when it comes to American credits, I'm afraid. So we'll get in touch together at a later stage, very soon indeed. Okay?
Thank you so much. We do have another question. Zeus is an architect and has a 5 years after BA back, probably not.
A Bachelor of Arts.
Yeah, it's BACC.
Right, a Bachelor of Arts. Yeah.
Okay, and he's interested in a lot of business. He's interested in business.
Okay.
He's been graduating with a high GPA of 3.45, 4.5.
Right.
So he's interested in applying. Mm-hmm. Do you think he could actually apply and follow your courses?
Well, I think you could. Well,
being an architect with 5 year plus.
Yes, you can definitely. You are, I would say, the perfect example, if I may, the perfect example I was just trying to draw using the example of this young lady, young student that was studying and working in the science environment, field of expertise. And at some stage, she wanted to learn in-depth knowledge and get in-depth knowledge about all managerial topics so as to combine its core competency together with the perfect knowledge of what business administration is about. In that particular context, yes, I would say you can indeed apply. And I would be happy to answer your additional question anytime.
So Hannah tells us that she already emailed you and she will forward it again.
Okay, lovely, great, okay.
Yasin is wondering, what is the tuition for the BBA year? That's a very interesting question.
That's for sure. The BBA tuition fees is 6,000 euro for the full year.
Thank you so much. We do have another guest today.
Okay.
Vitran, could you please?
Hello, Vitran.
Hello. Good morning. Pandemic, isn't it?
You are the director of the Management of International Business Program. Welcome.
That's good. Good morning.
Could you say a few words about your program to our viewers?
Yeah, very.
In French or in English, both of them.
Starting with English.
Well, I've been I started with some French and then I switched to English. So.
Because the questions are in English, though.
Brilliant. Very good morning and welcome. We are a part of the IENIS family, and I'm at the moment running this MIB program, Management of International Business. The program runs for 2 years. The first year would be more of understanding the concepts of international business, and the second year would be more concerned with the skills for running the international project all across the world. So, in a brief nutshell, it's a program dedicated for students who would like to learn more of international projects for multinational and startup companies.
Thank you. We do have another question from Yassin. He would like to know, does the BBA degree qualify us after to apply for other business master degrees in IAE Nice?
Yes, it does indeed. So as I told you, the BBA is an undergraduate degree, which is at level, well, A level plus 3 years, okay? So in French, I would say it's a licence 3, and in English, it would be a bachelor's degree, right? So then at the end of your BBA year, you will be entitled to apply for, well, international masters. For the 2 years of the international masters, okay? But yes, indeed, you can do so.
Thank you. We have another question from Zeus. He wants to know, do we need to write a motivation letter for the submission? Because he already has written one.
All right. Okay. Is it still for the BBA or?
Still for the BBA,
anyway, for any of our degrees.
And he would like also to know what are the needed documents for the submission.
Okay.
And there's a website for that.
Yes, there's a platform and the application. Sorry, my mask. I'm a bit cautious about that. But it's difficult to speak out and use and leave my mask.
Especially with glasses.
Bear with me. Sorry about that.
Yeah. especially when you have sinus problems.
Yeah.
So, coming back to the BBA. Yes, there'll be a platform, an application platform, which will be available as of March the 1st. Is that right?
It is.
Okay, so, well, very soon that application platform will be available for you to create your account and enter documents which are requested in order to apply for any type of degree at IAE Nice anyway. So, well, you may not have all the documents which are requested at once, but you can start creating your file within this particular platform, and you can then feed your account step by step once you've just received your documents. For sure, a resume as well as an application letter is definitely what is expected from each of you.
And write it carefully. Because it does count.
Well, I mean, a resume should always be written carefully.
You know, I mean, the letter.
And the letter as well,
yeah.
For sure.
Thank you. We do have another question from Sophia, and I think this one is from the MIB.
Brilliant.
Yeah. She would like to apply for the master's degree, and she noticed that one of the requirements is to have either a TOEIC or a TOEFL. And she has a CAE certificate, and she had obtained it in June 2019. And would it be okay?
To answer to this question, it's a very good question, but my answer is no, we don't accept those.
Yeah.
The only test which we are acceptable here, it's TOEFL, TOEIC, IELTS, that sort of.
Zeus has it, though.
Yeah, so I'm sorry, you got to go and take a test, not a COVID test, but a TOEIC or TOEFL, and it would take 3 months. I suppose you're good in English, you know, you just give a shot and see how things work, and you should be able to do that, yeah?
Okay. Is there a score, a minimum score?
Yeah, 750 for TOEIC. And then IELTS, I think it's 7.5 and 6.5, I suppose. So if you want for further information, you can go and check our website, and that gives you a good amount of information of what is the scores acceptable here. But try to give a shot and see how that works. Yeah.
Again, all the links are in this description below.
True.
So we do have a question in French now.
Yeah.
Yay!
Allez.
Bonjour. J'ai vu que les conditions d'admission pour le master MIB ne requièrent plus le score message IAE. Ça, c'est très particulier cette année aussi.
Oui.
Cependant, les étudiants ayant déjà fait le score IAE seront-ils favorisés?
Good question. Ça dépend. Est-ce que je peux parler en anglais ou...
En français, c'est une question de Maëva.
D'accord. Écoutez, cette année, si vous avez un peu de problème avec le test SIM, si vous avez déjà... je ne peux pas vous répondre à cette question parce qu'on ne peut pas vous dire si on favorise les étudiants qui ont déjà fait des tests. Pour le moment, on n'avait pas cette instruction ou les informations. Je ne peux pas vous donner mauvaises informations. Je préfère vous regarder notre site web, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
Donc, Maëva, pas davantage si vous aviez déjà passé le score SIM. OK. Nous attendons d'autres questions, peut-être de personnes qui ont besoin d'informations plus approfondies sur certains masters. Alors, Maëva vous remercie.
Merci à vous.
Sophia vous remercie également. So, either in English or in French, you can choose. So, whichever you're comfortable with. Alors, en français.
Il y a un autre.
En français, bonjour, est-ce que les élèves de LEA sont acceptés dans le master MIB?
Langue étrangère appliquée.
Absolument.
Très bonne question. Si vous avez passé les cours qui sont autour de gestion, c'est plutôt acceptable. Parce que la plupart des cours ici en MIB, on a beaucoup de cours, surtout en anglais. Et de plus, vous avez beaucoup de cours basés sur la gestion. Par exemple, comptabilité, finance. Après, vous avez des cours de marketing, cours de droit, cours de vente et cours d'innovation et cours de risque. Et ont besoin de la connaissance de gestion dedans. Donc, je préfère que les étudiants ils ont un peu de connaissance dans quelques matières de gestion. Donc, on favorise les étudiants, bien sûr.
Il me semble qu'en LEA, il y a un petit tronc commun de gestion, deux langues
et une option. Ouais. Pourquoi je conseille les étudiants pour améliorer leurs compétences, surtout en comptabilité et finance, parce que c'est très, très important, surtout dans les projets internationaux, on a besoin de faire des budgets, retour d'investissement, mesurer le risque, mesurer une autre chose qui est très importante, mesurer la performance de chaque projet. Donc, c'est très, très important pour voir la connaissance de gestion dans les projets internationaux. Donc, votre connaissance de gestion, c'est pas négligeable. Merci.
Entendu, merci beaucoup. Another question from Yassine in English then, for the BBA. If holding a degree from English-speaking country and a degree is in English, do I still need to pass TOEFL or IELTS test?
No, that is not the case. No, if you come from an English-speaking country or if you hold a degree which was already passed in English, no, you do not. And anyway, to join our BBA, you do not have to go and sit for TOEFL or IELTS. That is not the case, okay? But a good command in English is definitely mandatory. So once being interviewed, and usually I am the one interviewing, so I can just assess and evaluate your level of English, and we go through specific topics so that I make it clear that you can or you cannot join because of your English speaking level.
Okay. Yassine, thanks to you.
You're most welcome.
Et Maëva vous remercie.
Merci, Maëva.
Okay, other questions? Don't be shy. Ne soyez pas timide. Allez-y, posez vos questions. Nous vous attendons et nos enseignants sont là et sont prêts à répondre à toutes les questions, peu importe si elles vous semblent erronées ou pas, vous pouvez y aller.
On est un peu comme Alexa aujourd'hui.
Exactement. Pour ne pas faire de différence, Google Home aussi. Ou Siri, comme vous préférez. Alors, toujours pas de questions. Ah ça y est. Ita, une question en français pour le MIB. Combien de langues pourrais-je étudier durant la formation MIB?
Anglais et français.
Anglais et français.
Basta.
C'est déjà pas mal.
Oui.
Est-ce que je peux me permettre un mot supplémentaire à l'attention de Maëva ou Ila, pardon. Ita. Excusez-moi parce que l'écran est un peu loin. Ita, si je peux me permettre un complément par rapport à Vikram Janawad, je voudrais spécifier que l'IAE propose à l'ensemble de ses étudiants une licence individuelle, donc personnelle, et gratuite, d'un an, pour l'utilisation de la plateforme Global Exam. Cette plateforme Global Exam permet à nos étudiants, pendant un an, d'étudier et d'enrichir leurs connaissances, bien évidemment en langue anglaise, mais également en français pour langue, comme, en tant que langue étrangère pour nos étudiants étrangers qui voudraient parfaire leur français pendant leur séjour en France. Ils peuvent, à travers de cette plateforme dont nous vous donnons l'accès pour un an, vous avez également la possibilité de passer, donc de vous entraîner au TOEIC pour l'anglais. Et vous avez également la possibilité de débuter ou d'enrichir vos connaissances dans trois autres langues qui sont l'espagnol, l'allemand et le mandarin. Et pour ceux dont je... En tout cas, ce dont je suis sûre, c'est qu'en ce qui concerne l'espagnol, vous avez aussi la possibilité de vous entraîner au passage d'une certification de type tel que le TOEFL pour l'anglais. Et je pense que c'est le DELE, D-E-L-E. Donc, vous voyez, à l'IAE, nous avons vraiment à cœur de vous donner la possibilité de parfaire vos connaissances en langue étrangère. L'anglais est de toute façon une langue qui est absolument incontournable. À l'IAE.
Je suis d'accord.
Mais il n'y a pas que l'anglais. Et au travers de cette plateforme dont vous bénéficiez donc d'un accès d'un an, c'est donc une licence qui vous est accordée 365 jours à compter de l'ouverture de votre licence, ce qui vous permet quand même de l'utiliser à tout moment, soit pour vous entraîner au passage du TOEIC, soit pour parfaire vos connaissances ou enrichir vos connaissances en langues étrangères.
Vous parlez de Global Exam.
Global Exam, tout à fait.
OK. Donc,
Sans compter que nous avons également, au niveau de l'université, un centre de ressources en langue qui est disponible aussi pour tous les étudiants.
C'est vrai.
Yeah. So Global Exam is something where students can practice on their own, and they can learn Portuguese, French, I think.
French as a foreign language.
Spanish,
definitely. German. As well as Chinese Mandarin.
So they can practice on their own, don't they? I mean, for a year, and then see where their level is going forward.
Definitely.
And then, once they are done, they'll get a certificate saying that they have passed the global exam criteria for passing.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is the case, but you can also, because Vikram, maybe you could say a word on the fact that at the end of your master's degree, you need to pass.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, absolutely true. I mean, anyone who has to state this is the case for all the students in IE.
All the masters.
Yeah, all of them. Any student who comes and joins our programs has to finish their year by passing a TOEIC or a TOEFL exam with a prerequisite. And in the case of TOEIC, it is 800. That should be the score you should have before getting a proper diploma from our school. So there's no doubt that by 2 years you'll be able to work well. and 800 would be the minimum accepted score to pass this degree program. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Alors, nous avons une question de la part de Lou, qui aimerait intégrer un master MIB ou IT. Elle a dû donc suivre le live que nous avons fait avec Mohamed Didier Alaoui il n'y a pas si longtemps. Et elle voudrait faire un double diplôme. Pour cela, est-ce qu'elle doit passer un test d'anglais? Donc, sa question est la suivante. Peut-il être valable seulement à la candidature pour le double diplôme ou aussi pendant la durée des cours à l'étranger? Alors, est-ce qu'elle devra le repasser puisqu'il ne sera plus valable jusque-là, puisqu'il n'est valable que 10 ans? And I don't mind if you want to answer in English.
I do not understand the question.
I don't understand the question either, to be honest. Il me semble que Lou voudrait savoir peut-être sur la... connaître la, la durée de validité du test d'anglais, probablement.
Test d'anglais, c'est pour 12 ans.
Deux ans.
Je crois que j'ai déjà eu Louise sur Instagram qui me posait la question et elle voulait savoir, je crois qu'elle a déjà passé son TOEIC, elle voulait savoir si du coup il serait valable pour les deux ans d'études qu'elle va faire à UCLA, il me semble que c'est ça.
Louise, est-ce que vous pouvez préciser votre question sur le chat et à ce moment-là nous reposerons la question à Monsieur Janawat. Nous avons une autre question de Zouz. Après combien de temps pouvons-nous passer l'interview? Il va soumettre ses documents en mars et à quel moment pense-t-il avoir l'interview? Il faut déjà que son dossier soit accepté.
Yeah. Are you asking? Is your question related to the BBA or to the MIB?
It is to the BBA because he's been asking questions.
Sorry
for the
about
BBA
that, but
so far.
I don't remember. Okay, so when it comes to the BBA, it's an ongoing process, right? It starts from the beginning of March and it will go on towards, well, the very beginning of the summer. So the soonest you can just, well, finalize all what's requested, the better it is in order for me to go through your whole file and propose for an interview. So I would say the sooner the better, but anyway, you know that it is an ongoing process. So I would like to kindly remind you that you can start creating your file anytime, and then step by step, you will feed your file with additional, well, documents once you get them, right? And I'm always having an eye on the applications for sure. So as soon as I see a file which is completed, which is, well, completed the way I can sort of try and evaluate somebody, I get in touch with you and we have an interview.
Okay, thank you. Another question from Zeus. When will the BBA start? Is it on October 2021?
Yes, for sure. Yeah. The BBA starts at the very, well, not at the very beginning of the academic year, because usually the academic year starts very early in September. But usually our BBA starts the very first week in October. For instance, this year it started October the 5th. So it will be exactly the same next year. Well, this coming month, October. And so then, if I may give you some additional details, so as you can understand how the year is split, you have lectures from October until the end of March. Then you're over with the lectures. And that is the time when internship period comes, right? So to validate and finalize your BBA year, you need to go and conduct a minimum of 4 and up to 6 month internship, professional internship, right? So I'd say that in between the end of March and the end of August, you need to find a professional internship that you conduct. You write your study project about it. And then at the very beginning of September, you will defend your study project in front of a jury. And once this last step is over, then you'll graduate.
Thank you so much. We do have another question from Emma. I think it is addressed to both of you. And I'm not sure we do have an answer for that.
Okay.
Emma would like to know if the courses will be online or at the campus. Oh. Excellent question.
Okay.
Vic. Go ahead.
You know, it has been a very sad year for a lot for, yeah. for many students yeah. for the last 1 year. And you know, don't think that you're not affected by your feelings. Of course we are. I mean, not just me, the whole university and the whole nation as such. I mean, we don't know how this pandemic will evolve, if there are other mutations coming around. Unfortunately, I can't answer the question right now. It depends on the evolution of the COVID crisis, and hopefully,
fingers crossed,
thank you. You know, we see a flattening of the curve, or if not, a proper reduction. And if that is the case, then we'll be in a jolly good position. And if we are in that jolly good position, I may not be able to answer this question in a straightforward manner. Maybe the university will take into consideration. And again, it not doesn't depend on the university as a nation. But, we're all in this together. And hopefully, if everything goes fine and the cases go drop down significantly, probably there will be cases that there will be a situation where you're open to go to the schools, and it doesn't specifically mean for our university. I think this applies for all the universities in France or all across Europe. Okay, I hope I can. That sounds an okay answer.
Hopefully by the end of the year.
Hmm. Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully. And so please be careful with the pandemic.
In the meantime.
Yeah. precautionary measures are always taken.
Can I maybe add a few words? When technically speaking, okay, I'd like to explain how it went at the very beginning of, this academic year.
Yeah.
Last October 2020, yeah. or last September,
yeah.
We had all students joining
yeah.
the EAE at that time,
yeah.
and we were able to, propose our lectures on site for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that I wanted to highlight and to stress out to you is that all our rooms now are fully equipped with cameras
yeah.
as well as sound systems.
Yeah.
Okay. And we have a virtual platform
yeah.
which enables us
yeah.
to propose our lectures
yeah.
online. So at some stage we had students sick.
Yeah.
It could have been because of COVID, could have been for anything.
Any reason.
Any yeah. reason. So yeah. first, we started with everybody yeah. joining us on site.
Yeah.
Then there was a time, roughly end of October, beginning of November, we had students staying home and some students still coming. And those who were staying home because they couldn't come for health issues, they could listen to our lectures and watch our lectures
yes.
through this particular process, technical a device and system, okay?
Yeah.
So as long as the government and our ministry enable and allows us to actually come as lecturers
yeah.
and offer our lectures on site, we can do so, all
sure.
right?
That's correct.
It is all a matter of governmental steps and measures
yeah.
that we cannot bypass anyway. But one point that is for sure is that as long as we are allowed to provide our students with on-site lectures, we have the technical abilities
yeah.
to do so.
Yeah.
Thank you. We do have a question in French now. Maëva voudrait savoir, elle a une question à propos du self-learning pour la troisième langue dans le programme du master MIB.
Mm.
Est-ce qu'il y a un niveau requis que l'on doit atteindre à la fin du master?
Si, oui. Vous pouvez commencer avec les compétences très basiques, mais quand vous faites un cours, c'est bien sûr, on a envie de voir votre performance. Donc, vous avez une note, vous avez bien sûr une note pour la première année de MIT, mais on n'avait pas des cours en deuxième année de MIT. Donc, voilà, vous avez une note à passer.
Donc effectivement, il y a une évaluation.
Bien sûr, bien sûr.
Évidemment, il faut avoir la moyenne.
Oui.
Okay.
Faites votre effort.
Merci beaucoup. Une autre question en français de la part d'Élise, qui voulait savoir si le MIB est le seul master compatible avec le programme MIM. Et sinon, quels sont les autres masters compatibles?
Très bonne question. Pour répondre à votre question, non. Vous pouvez également postuler dans les autres programmes. Ah, vous avez la possibilité pour aller à MIM, même avec BBL, j'imagine, avec les autres programmes. Moi, je ne peux pas répondre pour les autres programmes. Moi, je pense oui, c'est possible. Oui, merci.
A question in English now. Yeah. Zeus, again, he's from Lebanon. And if he is accepted, how can he apply for the visa to France? Does the university help in that issue? The university helps. We do have a whole department for that. So, what can you say to Zeus?
Is that for you?
It is. Zeus is applying for the BBA.
Okay. So there is a national platform called Campus France. Okay. So usually you need to go through, depending on the countries, but I would say that I would definitely go and investigate yourself on Campus France website, because they are the official representative of our, well, French government for all foreign students who are considering studying in France, right? And probably what happens is that Campus France is requesting from you a letter that states that you want to study and that you've been accepted to join one of our degree and one of our master or BBA, for instance. And in that particular case, we have our international relations department who will issue a certificate, a letter that states that indeed you are applying to enroll our BBA program, if that is the case, our MIB program, if it is so, so that you can testify and show evidence that you are indeed willing, you are willing to join one of our diplomas.
Thank you. On repasse en français.
Très bien.
Lou, qui a précisé sa demande pour le master MIB ou IT. Donc pour l'entrée au master MIB ou IT, je dois passer un test d'anglais, donc dans les prochains mois, en Master 2. Mm. J'aimerais faire un double diplôme à UCLA.
Master 2 ou Master 1?
En Master 2.
Master 2, ok.
Lors de ma candidature pour UCLA, mon test sera-t-il toujours valable? Mon test sera toujours valable, mais pas pendant la durée des cours à LA. Est-ce que cela suffit que mon test soit valable durant la candidature ou doit-il aussi être valable durant l'échange?
Le prérequis est toujours la même chose. Donc voilà, si vous avez passé cette année, c'est-à-dire au mois de juin, je pense, et donc c'est valable jusqu'à 2 ans. Donc, UCLA, le programme de UCLA, j'imagine, c'est pour un an, donc vous êtes tranquille. Hein?
Ok, merci.
Merci.
Alors, autre question de Maeva qui nous parlait tout à l'heure du self-learning. Donc, quel est le niveau final de langue requis? Peut-on commencer à apprendre une langue ou serait-il plus judicieux d'améliorer une langue plutôt que d'en commencer une nouvelle pour le self-learning?
You know, I mean, it depends on where you would like to take your journey to what level. Right.
Oui.
Yeah. I mean, we are giving you an opportunity for all the students of IEEE, just not one specific program, if they would like to improve their language skills. Now, Manuel, it's I shouldn't be saying this, but we
careful, you're recorded.
Definitely it's not a center for linguistic studies, definitely not. It's just a platform where students are given the opportunity to improve their language, which is very important for any person. Now, assuming that you would like to make your career or you fancy learning a language which you like a lot, probably Spanish, and then you fancy working in Spanish-speaking countries, and you have to scale up your level at one point, and if you think you can do that in a year's time, good enough. Thank you very much, you can do that. If you like to scale up more and go for another year more, yes, you could. And Global Exam is a platform which is assisting and facilitating students, not just the students of MIT or BBA, if I may.
It's all of our students.
Yeah. And
benefit from that, yeah.
The question came from,
Maiva.
Maiva, you choose a language which you fancy learning, and then you have the Global Exam, and you can go and, it's a cross-sectional, a very massive platform.
Yeah.
Go and enter and see how it looks like. It looks like, for the first time, like a massive ocean, and then you can start discovering, is it Atlantic Ocean or Pacific Ocean, on what scale would you like to take it? And I think you do a wonderful job. That's just very helpful too. Yeah, and if you would like to do that for a year and then go on for another year, fair enough, thank you. You could do that, yeah?
It's a personal choice.
Personal choice, of course. And plus, school is there to give you that foundation, and then how you would like to stir that, you are the pilot. And if choose the destination, and I wish you a happy journey, right?
Thank you. We do have another question in English for the VBA.
All right.
Lee would like to thank you for the presentation.
Yes, welcome.
How many hours of in-class study were there be per week?
All right. Okay, that's a very good question. Thank you. Actually, all our classes are just concentrated in 3 days a week, okay? So that you can share your time in between classes, studying, and, keeping a part-time job, if you wish so, all right? So the BBA program is being taught in class on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays.
Mm-hmm.
And usually you start lectures very early in the morning, usually it's 8, all right? But it doesn't last later than 5 usually, okay? So Mondays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays every week from beginning of October until the end of March, including exams. And then it's your journey onto a professional internship period, which can last from 4 months until, till 6 months, to 6 months.
Thank you so much. We have a question from Zeus. In French, then.
Mm-hmm.
Zeus, est-ce que l'université peut nous aider concernant l'hébergement à Nice? Et en d'autres termes, y a-t-il des foyers spécifiques qui appartiennent à l'IAE pour les étudiants?
Alors, il n'y a pas de foyer spécifique qui appartient. La question est posée en français.
En français. Okay. But I think Zeus speaks English.
Okay, but anyway, I'll speak French for a change. Non, il n'y a pas, l'IAE ne possède pas d'appartement ou de possibilités d'hébergement spécifiques pour nos étudiants. La structure qui fédère la plupart des structures étudiantes s'appelle le CROUS, C-R-O-U-S. Et donc, toutes les structures, les établissements d'hébergement pour étudiants sont gérés par le CROUS. Et il y a également, au travers du CROUS, de nombreux particuliers qui placent des annonces afin de louer leur propre chambre ou leur propre appartement aux étudiants et qui laissent des annonces au sein des CROUS eux-mêmes. Donc, pour répondre clairement à votre question, je regrette, mais nous n'avons pas de facilité d'hébergement propre à l'IAE. Ça n'existe pas.
Merci beaucoup. Je rajoute que sur le site de l'IAE, il y a une page qui s'adresse aux étudiants français ou anglophones en expliquant comment trouver un logement sur Nice. Donc, il peut très bien consulter le site en français ou en anglais. Il aura les renseignements à ce moment-là et des liens utiles.
D'accord.
Voilà. Merci beaucoup. Alors, pour l'instant, toujours pas de questions, de nouvelles questions. Est-ce que vous voudriez ajouter quelque chose, tous les deux?
C'est juste pour...
Voilà, in French or in English.
Both matters, you know. Firstly, I would like to say thank you, Lou. You know, my personal request, please pass your English test and make sure that you're applying for both MIB program and as well as the UCLA program. And, if you can pass the test by June, it's valid for two years.
Years.
Yeah. And so that would be a jolly good news for yourself. And if you got a good grade, like that good score, that's 800, 850. I've had cases where students have gone 960 out of 960. I'm not lying. I'm being honest with you. 960 out of 960. So there's huge competition. Well, of course, I mean, you know, it's a part of the life. But you give your best, give your shot, and see how that works. Then if you get 850 or 800, that's a very good news. And then I wish you the best, okay? Please try, okay?
Well, if you do go to Los Angeles, your English will definitely be improved.
Yeah, a bit of Spanish as well, if you like.
And a bit of Spanish also, yeah. Sonia, would you like to add something?
Peut-être quelques mots en français,
allez.
Et puis je dupliquerai en anglais, pourquoi pas, s'il le faut. Quelques mots sur la marque IAE. Si, vous
absolument, bien sûr.
Si je peux. La marque IAE est une marque qui est en fait disponible sur l'intégralité du territoire français.
Oui.
L'IAE Nice fait partie d'un réseau.
IAE France.
IAE France. Et donc, il y a des instituts d'administration des entreprises qui se trouvent, bien évidemment à Nice, mais dans d'autres métropoles de France. Nous formons un réseau puissant, nous formons un réseau reconnu et nous formons un réseau qui est apprécié des entreprises. Nos étudiants sont très heureux lorsqu'ils reviennent nous voir ensuite de pouvoir, la plupart du temps, jouer le rôle d'ambassadeur dans leur entreprise afin de pouvoir proposer des stages, des opportunités d'alternance ou des premiers emplois à nos propres étudiants en cours de finalisation, en cours de diplomation.
Oui.
Je voulais insister là-dessus parce que nous sommes fiers d'appartenir à ce réseau IAE France. Nous sommes une très belle et très dynamique communauté d'enseignants au sein de l'IAE de Nice et on est toujours là pour d'abord comprendre quels sont vos objectifs et vous proposer et vous conseiller par rapport au chemin que vous voulez entreprendre. Donc, notre but, ça n'est pas simplement de vous dire « Venez, rejoignez le MIB, rejoignez un master de l'IAE, rejoignez le BBA. » Chacun fait son choix. Mais ce dont vous pouvez être sûr, c'est que notre équipe d'enseignants est là pour avant tout comprendre vos objectifs. Et en regard de ces objectifs, nous voyons comment nous pouvons utilement vous conseiller pour faire les bons choix. Nous faisons partie de l'Université Côte d'Azur.
Oui.
Tous nos diplômes sont des diplômes universitaires.
Do I need to translate in English or is it just understandable?
No one is asking for it.
Okay, okay, so I'll just... I think it's pretty understandable.
No one's got COVID here.
You could.
I could? Okay then. Well, just as a recap, I was just telling that IAE Nice is part of a larger network, which is IAE France. Institut d'administration des entreprises does exist in several other towns, metropoles, okay? So
We are a powerful, successful, and recognized network that companies do know and that companies do appreciate when it comes to hiring our graduates.
Yeah.
All right. And another thing that I was just trying to, well, share as a message is that we are very proud of being part of this teaching community at EONIS, and we are also very proud of our alumni, because our alumni, when they come back to us, they are just acting as perfect ambassadors, so as to spread the word on what EONIS is offering. Mm. And a lot of them are just offering opportunities for internship, apprenticeship opportunities, as well as first jobs for our newly, freshly graduates. That was my message.
Thank you so much. Would you like to say something?
Yeah, just a few words for international. I think that there are a lot of students who apply for international management of international business. They come from all parts of the world. I mean, yeah. Sonia is a part of our team, has always been, will always be. And what I would like to give you a small clarification of management of international business program. This is a very different sort of a program, and I'm not saying very high about this program. Of course, I'm proud of our program. You know, what makes it different? Well, the thing that makes MIB very different is the skills that you gather. What are the skills you gather for doing international projects on an international scale? First one is to understand what's the concept of your business, okay? What's the concept of the service? What's the budget you need for running this business? Okay, what's the return of investment which is required for running this business? That's an important asset. Going forward, how do you make this project, implement, execute them, test them, launch them, and then see how it performs? Well, this is the whole thing which runs around project. On top of that, we need to have compliance. Okay? It doesn't necessarily mean compliances which are applicable to European Union. It applies to North America and other countries. So you got to know what are these compliance measures, what are the rules and regulations going for doing businesses. On top of that, once the project is up and running, we need to make an assessment. Okay, this project, does it come with a certain risk? How do we measure those risks? Okay, what are the factors which are taken into account for risk? How can we mitigate those risks? And once this is all done, we go and see how the project is performing, okay? We make an analysis of the performance and see how, what the customer is making out of this project, what the suppliers are making out of this project, what are the partners making out of this project, what are the distributors making out of this project. So it's on an international scale, and we need a set of skills. I can repeat if you like. Skills required: budgeting skills, taxation skills, risk management skills, performance management skills like KPI and KRIs. You need skills for understanding the legal frameworks. On top of that, most important thing these days is corporate social responsibility and how we measure that corporate social responsibility of your uni international project going forward in any countries where you would like to apply. So these are some of the considerations we take in while teaching for the management of international business. So when you come here, you come here to study the whole package. There's not just one element that we are very focused on, but they are all in this together. So it's a package of all of these principal components: corporate social responsibility, budget management, taxation, project management, risk assessment. Then going forward, how do you market them? How do you brand them? How do you make sure that the people are getting value out of this product or services that you offer? So this is the whole value propositions we offer from Masters of International Business. Do you have anything to add on this, please?
We do have a last question from Zeus.
Yeah.
Okay, and then these live sessions will be over. So Zeus would like to know, after the 6 months of academic courses, does the school help us in finding the best internship for the coming last 6 months?
Okay.
We had this question every time.
I can guess so, yeah. Yes, we help you, but we will not find the internship for you. we provide you with some assistance because we have platforms through which you can investigate and find suitable internship opportunities. Those internship opportunities are posted by the companies that we are partnering with, right? And I was just saying a word about our alumni who are coming back and offering some opportunities. Here they are, but not only. So indeed, we have tools that help you and provide you some assistance so that you can investigate and find the perfect internship. Mind you, we also provide you assistance with writing the right type of resume, okay? And that is really important, being able to shape the right resume level as well as the right motivation level letter, all right? And we have so many, well, the BBA cohort is a very international one.
True.
Students come from various parts of the world, you come with different cultures,
yeah.
And you all come usually with your own personal goals,
yeah,
because you are onto a very personal journey. Mind you, at the end of the year, you all share exactly the same knowledge,
yeah,
which is being familiar with all different topics that are so important when it comes to, well, gaining managerial insight and being able to understand the challenges and the best practices when it comes to business administration.
Thank you so much. Zeus is very interested in the BBA. And he says, thank you for all your help. I was interested in the BBA and now I became more and more interested.
My pleasure.
So we'll see Zeus from Lebanon very soon. Thank you so much, both of you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Merci à nos téléspectateurs.
Merci
à vous tous.
Et à très bientôt. See you soon.
Bye-bye. For now.
Il n'y a pas de questions, non?
There's no questions and the session is over.
Okay.
Therefore, bye for now.
Bye.
Merci, Emma.
Au revoir.
Because